pop the questions out of my head, and we're gonna see how it's gonna work out, right? Okay, so first, welcome here in Poland. I'm glad to see you here, and how was your trip?
My trip was awesome. I don't know, should I keep the level down here or what?
No, don't care about that.
The trip was awesome. I didn't sleep for a whole maybe 36 hours. And so when I got here, I was a little cranky, but as soon as I got my nap in, it was pretty good. Today was awesome. You know, woke up refreshed and, you know, saw some of the city, and it's a beautiful place. So, yeah, the trip went well.
Okay, so you didn't have a jet lag or anything?
I had a big-time jet lag, yeah. When I got here, I was jet lagged for a few hours, and we couldn't check into the hotel, so it was a little kind of funky. I was jet lagged big time, but now I'm totally back on schedule, so yeah.
Cool, awesome. So tell me, how long you're on YouTube?
That's the first thing.
I've been on YouTube since, I've had an account since 2006, and I've actually only started like being consistent with it and putting out like content on the regular as of January 2010.
Okay, and what made you come on YouTube, you know, with the whole big thing?
I don't know if it happens for everyone, but for me it happened by mistake. I had no idea this is going to be a big time thing for me. You know, we put out one video, and it kind of just snowballed into there. People asked for more, so we kept putting them out. And then after that, I just kind of used my channel as kind of a content hub where I would just put out whatever kind of media and content that I wanted to put out.
Okay, and any plans in soon future? Can you tell us something about that? Some maybe just a tip, a secret?
Well, I think for my channel, I think we're just going to kind of continue to kind of put out more content, more shows, more Dunkin' Rocks episodes, and just more stuff. I mean, a lot of people think that with YouTube you can just limit yourself to one thing on one channel, but I mean, the way I think is you can do whatever. If you want to put anything out, put it out. So my channel is kind of more dedicated to series kind of stuff. So we're just going to keep making shows, making more of what we're currently doing, and just hopefully it will turn out for the best and we get bigger with the channel.
Okay, well, one more question I wanted to ask you. How did you came up with the sex Viking thing?
I didn't know anyone knew about the sex Viking. I thought it was just me and Dunkin' Rocks that people knew about. I have a buddy who's a ladies' man. And I'm not the sex Viking, by the way, but I think that's kind of public knowledge, but some people are on the fence, they don't know. So my friend kept coming to me, he was like, oh yeah, I'm going to start this blog, I'm just going to start writing about this, or I'm going to write a book about how to get with women, how to do all this stuff, and just relationship advice. So I said, you know what, I think we can take that idea and take it one step further. I think we can take it and just make it kind of like a YouTube series where he just gives like, you know, 2 to 3 to 4 minute kind of little episodes of just, you know, relationship advice. So how we didn't really have a title for the thing when we started. We just had a wig, a beard, and he had sunglasses because he wanted to like disguise himself. And so I went downstairs and I found an old Halloween Viking helmet, and I said, let's just throw this on, see what happens. And I was like, you kind of look like a Viking with the hair and the beard and the thing. I was like, let's just call it the sex Viking. So that's how that came about.
Oh, that's sweet. And do you think those advice really worked?
Absolutely. We hear people, you know, people comment, but then some people like to kind of stay anonymous because it's kind of like you don't really want to comment or do anything on the internet that's kind of public when it comes to like sex advice or relationship advice. But we have a lot of people come to me or they'll email me and be like, hey, this sex Viking stuff, it really works. It's like it really helped me out. So it's, I guess it does work. Yeah.
So guys, remember, take advice from the Viking, you know. They're clapping for Jimmy, not for you.
Oh, I thought they were clapping for the sex Viking. Damn it.
All right, well, how long are you going to stay in Poland?
Till Monday.
Till Monday.
Yeah.
Are you feeling bad because you're staying just till Monday, or are you feeling cool that you're going to go back to States?
No, I'll tell you the truth. If I could, I'd probably stay a few extra days. But I have just other obligations and other things I have to attend to. But I'm really glad that I was able to spend, you know, today and tomorrow and a little bit of yesterday here. But, yeah, if I could, I'd probably want to spend some more time because it's awesome here.
Okay, cool. I'm glad. It was great to meet you, and hope you're going to have fun.
I'm already having fun, and it was great to meet you, too. So, whoosh, there you go.
Sweet, thanks.
Excellent. All right, dude, that was great. That was awesome.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.